This news update is brought to you by.
This is how we flow. All the offers are quite exciting, and the prices will leave you smiling. Everybody's got a cheerful glow.
Get the new Samsung J5 plus 1 gig free data, starting at just $345.
It's Wednesday, December the 16th, 2015, and this is your Barbados Today Morning News Update. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. Thanks for joining us. In our top story this morning, the company of a garbage hauler who was at the center of recent protests against government's tipping fee and its impact on the environment is now back in the spotlight, but for all the wrong reasons. Ernest King's company, Quality Business Services, is being identified as the main perpetrator of illegal dumping at Butts St. Thomas. Environmental health officials visited Butts yesterday to get a first-hand look at the illegal dumping site. Among those on the scene were Acting General Manager of the Sanitation Service Authority, Roslyn Knight, Mangrove Landfill Superintendent Carl Boxill, and a team from Barbados Today. It was business service that was retained by the Elegant Hotel chain and Lantern Mall to dispose of their garbage at the landfill. Knight contended that companies are responsible for ensuring their garbage is disposed of in the right way.
The generators of the garbage, it is their responsibility to ensure that the persons that are collecting and disposing for them are doing it in a proper manner. This garbage has been collected from a hotel group and disposed in a cart road.
How do you know it was from a hotel room?
All the evidence there reflected is from the hotel group. Oh, how many are they? Restaurants, hotels. That's the evidence.
A 37-year-old Austrian tourist cheated death yesterday afternoon when he plunged several feet over the cliff near the Animal Flower Cave in St. Lucie. However, the visitor, whose name could not be ascertained up to last night, sustained a broken hand and foot. Police spokesman Station Sergeant Roland Cobbler says the incident occurred shortly after 5 p.m. With the European Union awaiting this country's request to access development funding under a more than $88 million regional program allocation, the Friend of Stewart administration is being assured that the European Union will not withhold development aid to it, despite concerns which the EU has over a series of human rights concerns. Resident EU ambassador to Barbados, the Eastern Caribbean, CARICOM and CARIFORUM, Michael Barfoot, told a press luncheon at Champers Rockley Christchurch yesterday afternoon that even though it is disturbed at the continued stigma and discrimination against members of the lesbian, gay, bisexual and transgender community, the existence of the death penalty, the lack of effective domestic violence legislation, increasing child abuse cases, and extraordinary long delays in delivering justice in the courts, the European community will not penalize Barbados when it came to giving aid.
And let me make it clear that the EU is not linking any of its actions or its aid to this, which is a question that I was asked before. We don't do that, and we never will in a situation we're in the Caribbean right now.
There's regional and international news after this short break.
'Twas days before Christmas, I had so much to do. Shopping, more shopping, and I was feeling blue. There's a mother, father, a wifey, and friend. Lots of things to buy, but there was no money to spend. I found the answer, the BT shopping spree. 15,000 in goodies, free, free, free. It's easy to enter, nothing hard to do. Follow my instructions and a winner can be you. Visit facebook.com/Barbados Today. Do it quickly and fill out your form to enter this spree. Look, I'm shopping at the cost you less mega store. Come down, fill your trolleys with goodies and more. And like me, you too can say, ho, ho, ho.
Secure your future, be financially strong. Since 1983, we have been there for you. A smart range of products, great tax benefits. We're the solution to your hopes and your dreams. The Barbados Workers Union Cooperative Credit Union. The Barbados Workers Union Cooperative Credit Union.
In news from the region now, Trinidad's energy minister has been given details of the natural gas shortage and its effects on the economy. We get the details in this report from TV6 News.
When Prime Minister Rowley announced that Trinidad and Tobago was suffering from a shortage of its bread and butter revenue earner, natural gas, he did not state the difference between the amount of billion cubic feet or BCF per day being produced and how much is actually needed. The energy minister announced those figures in the parliament.
Natural gas is currently being produced at a rate of 3.8 BCF per day when we have a demand for as much as 4.2 BCF per day. So there is a shortfall that we are currently faced with.
The Ryder Scott report stated Trinidad and Tobago had 22.7 trillion cubic feet or TCF of proven, probable and possible gas reserves by the end of 2014, down from 25.24 TCF in 2012.
We cannot sustain an industry at this rate. And the only way we can replace our reserves to increase production is by drilling. Exploration and production costs in the oil and gas sector are quite high. Member for Carony Central spoke about the $2.1 billion BP will have to expend on its Juniper project. Offshore rigs currently operate at upwards of $360,000 per day.
She also said the National Gas Company would have constructed offshore pipelines in 2012 at a cost of $3.4 billion and onshore pipelines for $36 million. The minister, however, did not paint a picture that is all gloom and doom.
Total capital investment by foreign and local companies in the energy sector is projected at over $3 billion a year in 2015 and 2016.
Internationally, the first manned spacecraft to land on the moon, Apollo 11, is making history again as a Soyuz spacecraft touched down at the International Space Station. For the last week, scientists have been scanning the command capsule that orbited the moon during this mission in an effort to give the public a virtual experience of what it was like inside. More in this BBC report.
Now, this is usually as close as anybody gets to the real thing, but this project means that anybody will soon be able to experience what it was like inside the capsule.
The interior has been off limits for decades, but creating a 3D model will give people a detailed view of an object that was once at the cutting edge of technology, but is now a museum piece.
Very little of it actually survives. There's some objects that are still on the lunar surface, which someday may come back to the National Collection or otherwise. But other than that, they're gone. This is the one sort of surviving piece of a very unique event in human history.
This is one of the most complex objects ever scanned. The interior is cramped and full of reflective surfaces that bamboozle the lasers, and it's difficult to see all the knobs and switches.
You can see we have a really small window of entry. We have a laser scanner here, which captures about 1 million points per second. So the real challenge is sort of getting into all the nooks and crannies, looking at the command module control panel. There's an incredible amount of detail that we need to capture.
And the sheer volume of data is overwhelming. New software had to be created to deal with it. First, a point cloud is created from the individual measurements of millions of laser points. That information is used to create a mesh, which becomes a surface model. Multiple scans from different viewpoints build up the image, which is overlaid with color from thousands of photographs. When complete, the movable model will give audiences access to an object many could only imagine before.
And on that note, we end our Barbados Today morning news update. However, you can join us again this afternoon. Until then, remember to log on to www.barbadostoday.bb, subscribe to our e-paper, email updates, or like us on Facebook. You can also catch us on Izumi Media in bus terminals or screenplay at supermarkets and gas stations near you. Also tune into Channel 101 on Floor TV and Mix 96.9 FM to get all the latest news and sports. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. Have a fantastic day.